Here is a video showing how to record a screencast using ScreenR. So if we have ScreenR open, it's screenr.com. I'm actually going to open another window so that we can see that we can record something. I'm going to just open the New York Times. And to sign in, I'm not signed in. You're going to have to either sign in with a Twitter account, a Facebook, a Google, or a Yahoo account. If you don't have any of those, I would advise creating a Google account. It'll give you the most options and has the most wide-ranging use. So I'm going to sign in with my Twitter account. And now it's going to connect my Twitter account to my screencast. And the first time you do this, you may have to click Allow. I'm going to sign in. And you can see my name is up here. This is me. I'm going to select record. And now it's going to detect Java. And it's going to ask me to allow Java and ScreenR to interact. They're going to access my computer. I'm actually going to select allow all from ScreenR so I don't have to answer this again. And now it's loading the screen recorder. Now I can see the screen recorder here. Right, so it's not recording as of yet, but I can see it's picking up my voice because the microphone is picking it up. I can resize how big I want this window to record. I'm actually going to take it back down so it records everything. Now, you have to leave this page open, but you do not have to record here. So I'm going to go to the place that I want to record, the New York Times, and say I'm showing how to do a search or to open up an article, something very simple. So I'm going to click record. It's going to give me a countdown. And now I start narrating my screencast. And I want to see what happened on Wall Street. And I click on there. You know, you have up to 5 minutes. It gives you a countdown here. I'm going to do something very quick here. So I'm going to click done. And now I see a preview of my screencast. I scroll down, and I have to give it a description. So I'm going to describe my screencast, posting a screencast to a blog. So I'm going to publish. I don't publish and tweet unless I intend to. You can publish and it won't go anywhere. It just goes into your screen. So I'm going to click publish. It's going to give me a publish line. Mine is not very long, so it's going to go rather quickly. If your video was about 5 minutes, it would take much longer. While it's doing that, I'm going to open up our site so that we can post it to a blog. I'm going to go view blogs, add, screen, R screencast. My screencast of the New York Times. That's all I need to write. So I'm going to go back. And now my screencast is ready to share. I can click share. And here I can get the URL. I'm going to click on copy. If I was publishing it to a website, I could get embedded. Just is not working on the website that we're using for our course. So I'm going to click copy. I'm going to go back to our blog. I'm going to highlight screencast. And I'm going to click link. And I'm going to paste in that link. Click OK. Make sure I go down to the bottom. And I always, just like we want to save things, I'm going to publish my post. And here, if I click on the screencast, it's going to take me to the video. And I can play it. And that's how you publish.
And now I start narrating my screencast.
Now we have a screencast within a screencast. So that's how you do it.